Bibles real quick to Isaiah chapter 43. Yes. How do you know that? I believe that in this season, and Juana, she said it, and Brother George read it. I believe that in this season that God is going to do something supernatural. How do you know that this is a season that God is getting ready to release supernatural provision? Yes. Amen. This is a year of release, a year of restoration, a year of the supernatural, amen, provisions of God. Amen. I don't care where you're at. Amen. In your life, if you will stay in fellowship with God and you'll obey His will, yes, amen. Amen. He promised He'll make a way for you.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. I don't know about y'all, but He's Jehovah Jireh, right? Yeah. He's our provider.
Yes,
amen. And I believe that God's supernatural provision is getting ready to show up in this season. Yeah. Amen. And I'm not going to be up here long. I'm going to read this and move on. Amen. Isaiah 43:19. He said, behold, look, behold, I will do a new thing.
That's right.
A new thing. Mm-hmm. Now it shall spring forth.
Yes, sir.
Shall ye not know it?
Yes, sir.
I will even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. Did you hear that? I believe that in this season that God is getting ready. Amen. To make a way out of no way.
Amen.
And actually what he was telling the children of Israel, amen, he said, I'm getting ready to do a new thing. Listen to the word new in the Hebrew means to repair, to rebuild, to renew oneself. I believe that in this season that God is getting ready to renew us. God is getting ready to restore. God is getting ready to, amen, it also means to rebuild. How many know that God is rebuilding our life? He restoring our life. You know, the Bible said that the just shall what? Shall live by faith. How many know that when you become born again, that God comes and He reframes your life. He reshapes your life. Amen. He prepares you for a whole new lifestyle. The scripture said the just shall live by faith. So in this new season, amen, that God is preparing us. Amen. That we're going to start living, amen, even more so this season by the supernatural. How many know that faith is living by the supernatural? Faith is not walking by what you can see. Faith is not walking by what you can feel. Faith is walking, amen, amen, by your spirit and by the word of God. And that's something, Christians, that we're not used to, because we used to walking by what we can see, what we can do by human effort and human ability. But God prophesied to Isaiah. He said, behold, I shall do a new thing.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
The word new also means to refresh.
Amen.
How many know that God is repairing?
Amen.
He's repairing us. And every broken thing in our life, He's healing us.
Amen.
How many know that? How can we go get other people delivered unless we're made whole?
Amen.
Right. Amen. And I feel like in this newness, in this restoration that God is doing for the church, I believe that He's healing us.
Amen.
He's healing us from our past. He's healing us from our rejection. He's healing us from our fears. He's healing us from our anxieties. He's healing our families. He's healing our home. But in this season, He said, I'm going to do a new thing. Somebody say new thing.
New thing.
So I don't care what it looks like. In 2017, God is getting ready to restore.
Amen.
That means God's getting ready to restore our families. God's getting ready to do something new in Faith International. God's getting ready to release a fresh anointing over this house. God is getting ready to add to this house daily. Amen. God is going to heal our marriages. He's going to heal our homes. Amen. He's going to heal our finances. He's going to heal our bodies. Amen. It's already been prepared. It's already been done before the foundation of the world.
Yes, Lord.
But because you don't have your new body yet, He has to repair what you have.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. Because in the regeneration, Lord have mercy. You know, we're actually living it. We're living in the regeneration.
Jesus.
And the rebirthing. And the restoring. So I believe that in this season, God is doing something new. He's restoring. He's rebirthing us. Then the scripture says in 2 Corinthians 5:17, if any man be in Christ, he say, he's a what? He's a new creature. He said, all things are passed away. Behold, all things are made new, and all things are of God. How many know that in this newness, in this restoration, that everything in our life is going to be like God? Everything in us is going to be of our Father, that we're going to have, amen, we're going to walk in His nature. We're going to walk in His character, because that's a part of the newness. That's a part of God repairing, of God restoring, of God renewing us.
Thank you, Lord.
In this season.
Thank you, Lord.
He says, shall ye not know it?
Yes.
The word know, that means to perceive, to discern, to recognize. How many know that in this hour, God is going to cause us to recognize, and then we're going to see the hand of God. We're going to be able to discern the move of God. We're going to be able to perceive that God is doing something new in this season.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Because he said, now listen to this. He said, shall ye not know it?
Thank you, Jesus.
In other words, he said, I'm going to cause you to be able to proceed. And I believe tonight, amen, every word that has been spoken from each and every person that's here, that God is, amen, God is letting us know that in this season, the one that He's getting ready to restore, He's getting ready to rebuild. Amen, He's going to make new again.
Yes, Lord.
One scripture said that He's going to restore the old places, the ruined places, the places that have been broken down.
Amen.
God is going to restore.
Amen.
So I prophesy and I speak over you tonight that in this season, God is getting ready to restore. God is getting ready to rebuild. God is getting ready to bless you. Amen. When you struggle, when you didn't have strength, in George read it in Isaiah 40, he said, I give strength to the faint, to the weak.
That's right. That's right.
How many know that in this season, that God is getting ready to restore? He says, shall ye not know it? In other words, shall ye not be able to perceive this thing?
Jesus. Shall
he not know it? That's actually what the word know means, to perceive. To discern.
Yes.
You're going to be able to, and how many know that in this season, as God mature up, we're going to be able to discern the move of God. We're going to be able to know what's the spirit and what's the flesh.
Yes, Lord.
Because God is going to cause us to be able to perceive, to discern, to be able to know what is Him and what's not.
Amen.
Because how many know that many people are being deceived because they can't discern or they can't perceive the move of God?
That's right.
But I believe that in this hour, God is going to cause us to be able to perceive. We're going to know the move of God. We're going to know what God is doing in this season. And then the Bible says He do nothing except He reveal it to His servant, the prophet, first. So when God get ready to move, God going to begin to reveal it to the church first.
Amen.
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 How many know that whenever God get ready to do something, He reveal it to His people first? He got to start with the church.
Amen.
Okay, let's finish reading. He said, behold, I will do a new thing. Now. He didn't say in the past, did he? He said, now, present tense. He said, it shall spring forth now. Now it shall spring forth. Now, present tense, right now. I believe that in this hour, even as we're speaking, I believe that the Spirit of God is supernaturally preparing us to walk into the blessings of God in this season. Doors going to open. Opportunities going to open. Your ministry is going to come forth. God is going to give you greater revelation, greater insight, greater wealth, greater increase. That's getting ready to come your way in this season.
Hallelujah.
He said, behold, I will do. He said, I'm going to do. God said, I'm not sitting around talking. He said, in this new season, I'm going to do it. It's an action. It's a verb. God is not sitting around talking about, oh, next year I'm going to do. Matter of fact, God has already done it. God has already met all your needs. God has already delivered your family. God has already blessed you with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. He's already done it.
Amen.
now it shall spring forth. It shall spring forth. Yes. Somebody says spring forth.
Spring forth.
Ooh, goodness, I'm so excited.
Amen.
That God is going to cause it to spring forth.
Yes.
Actually, when you look this up in the Greek, it actually means to grow up.
Yes.
It also means to bud.
Yes.
Listen to this. Or to bear forth. How many know that in this season, God is going to cause us to produce some fruit?
Amen.
And in this season, people are going to see a manifestation of God's presence and power.
Yes. Yes. Amen. Yes.
Because it's going to do what? It's going to spring forth.
Yes.
It's going to spring forth. It's going to come forth. It's going to grow up out of you.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
You know, the Bible talks about that out of your belly shall what? Shall flow rivers of living water. Y'all remember that the Samaritan woman that met Jesus at the well?
Yes,
ma'am.
Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus asked her for something to drink.
Thank you, Lord.
She said, how is it that you, being a Jew, ask me, a Samaritan, to drink? Because the Jews don't have no dealing with us. But Jesus told her, listen, woman, if you had known who I was, do y'all understand? Y'all got to hear me now. That this woman was not able to perceive that there was Jesus.
Right.
But God said, in this season, we're going to know. We're going to be able to perceive Jesus. There are people in church right now that don't even perceive Jesus. They don't know the move of His Spirit. They don't know the anointing of God. So that tells me that you can be in the house of God and still not be able to, amen, to discern and to know God's Spirit.
Yes.
Just like this Samaritan woman. But Jesus told her, He said, listen, woman. He said, if I drink what you have, I'm going to need some more. But He said, if you drink of what I give you, it shall be like a well down on the inside.
Yes.
That He said, and it shall spring forth unto eternal life. How many know that this well, this new thing that God is doing, amen, and I say it's a new thing, it's a repairing, amen, God is actually restoring through Jesus. He is already restored. He's already made all things new, but we got to receive it, and we got to be able to discern and to know the move of the Spirit.
Yes.
In order to walk in what God has for us. Because I'm convinced of this, and I'm not just convinced of this, I know this. If you can't perceive it, or discern it, you'll miss it. A lot of people in 2017 are going to miss the move of God because they're still following their tradition. They can't discern the move of God. They're still stuck under legalism and under the law and under the flesh, and they haven't shifted with the Spirit of God to know what has freely been given to them. And we know that God has given us all that. God wants us to be in fellowship. God wants to talk to us. Amen?
Amen.
And that's a part of the restoring. That's the part of the rebuilding, is that God is rebuilding our relationships like He did with Adam.
Amen. Hallelujah.
That now I can walk in God can talk to me.
Amen.
He can speak to me.
Amen.
Okay, I'm going to get out your way now. He said, behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall ye not know it? Now, listen to this. I will even make a way. I will even make a way. Now listen to this. This word way here means to make a road or a course. Because God said, listen. He said, in the midst of the wilderness, it won't even be a way, but I'm going to make a road. He said, I'm gonna make a way for you.
Yes.
I'm going to create a course.
Yes.
Yeah, y'all remember that scripture that talks about that God said, I'll lead you in the paths of righteousness for my name's sake.
That's right.
The word path there in the Hebrew means a already chartered course. That means that this road that you're about to take, somebody else been on it. How many know that what you're going through, somebody else been through it? Just in case you think you're the only one been through it, amen, I'm here to tell you today, you ain't the only one been through what you're going through. You just feel like you're special, but you ain't that special. Everybody's been through what you've been through, but we all been through it a little different.
Yes.
So what we're going through, it's somebody else been through it. It's a path that every man has taken a certain path. Lust of the eye, of the flesh, pride of life, all that stuff. That's how Jesus was tempted. He was tempted likened to his brother. So every path that you've taken, he's taken. But the Bible said, yet he did not yield to sin. So he said, I will make a way, a road, a path. My goodness. Isn't that something? Did he do it with the children of Israel?
Amen.
When they came up against the Red Sea, he parted the waters.
Yes, yes.
And the Bible said they walked through on dry land.
Yes.
When they was hungry, he rained manna down from heaven. When they was thirsty, he caused water to come out of a rock.
Yes.
We're talking about a supernatural God. And that's what I'm saying in 2017, that God is getting ready to show his supernatural provision. Amen. When men say it won't happen, God will make it happen for you if you love him and if you are a child of covenant. If you're in covenant with God, if you're born again, then the promises of God are yea and amen.
Amen.
Amen. How many know God never said no to his promises?
Yes.
Now, he might say no to what you want,
amen,
but if it lined up to this with this word, then it's yes, yes, yes. That's why we got to seek God's face and ask him, Lord, is this what you want me to do? Because sometimes we take on things that God don't want us to have, and we wonder why it's not working, because God said, I never told you to pick it up from the first time.
That's right.
You wanted it.
That's right.
And then you, because you were so, man, you were so caught up in it.
Oh,
then you stamped, took God and like a stamp and stamped it. And God said, I never approved. So we got to make, what's my point? We got to make sure that we're able to discern,
amen,
what God wants us to do.
Yes.
And I say this.
Thank you, Lord.
It's a lot more profound than what I'm saying. You got to be led by your spirit and not by your emotions, not by your mind.
Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Your spirit got to lead you. See, the intelligence, the wisdom, and the revelation that we receive, it ain't something that you read. You don't learn this at school. You learn this from the Holy Ghost. It ain't got nothing to do with your intellect. It got everything. The only way that we can hear the voice of God this day, each and every last one of us that's sitting here today, is because the Holy Spirit that's on the inside of us, he speaks to us. He gives us revelation, right, Drilla? He tells us things, such questions that we know we're not able to understand and perceive. Think about some of the things that you didn't understand in time past. But now the Holy Spirit is starting to open up to you things that you didn't understand. Why? Because you get to the place now where you are able to hear the Holy Spirit that's on the inside of you, and you quit trying to do it with your head.
Amen.
Because sometimes God will give you revelation. You go, oh my God, if I, Lord, I didn't even think of that. Mm-hmm. Guess what God just told me? Why? Because I'm learning to walk by my spirit. And that's why I said when he breathed into Adam the breath of life, he breathed his intelligence, his wisdom, his understanding.
Hallelujah.
He breathed spirit. Good God Almighty. Alright, y'all, I'm gonna give that to y'all. Okay. He said, behold, I'll do a new thing, and it shall spring forth. Shall ye not know it? I will even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. My goodness. A way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. Did you hear that? So what am I, Pastor Warren, what you saying to us today? God just said this simply to me, said this to me today, coming, because I'm saying, God, what am I going to say? He said, tell him, I'm getting ready to do something supernatural.
Amen.
that I'm going to make a way.
Amen.
So look, amen. You got to have, like Ron Parson said, you got to have expectation.
Amen.
You got to walk around with your neck out. You walk around like you're looking for something. You know how it is when your nose and you want to know everybody's business. That's where you ought to be. Every morning you get up, God, I'm looking for something. I'm looking for a miracle. I'm looking for a financial miracle. I'm looking to get somebody healed. I'm looking to get somebody delivered. Why? Because I have an expectation. Amen. I'm believing for something great to happen in this season.
Yeah.
But it's going to be supernatural.
Yes.
It's going to be supernatural. My goodness.
Thank you, Lord.
So God said, I'll make a way. I'll make a road for you. I'll give you direction. Let's read one more scripture and we'll be done. Let's go to Galatians chapter 6, verse 9. I love this verse of scripture. And I know we all been through a lot this year. I've been through a lot. We've all been through a lot and going through a lot in our families and finances and everything else. But how many know it's going to be all right?
Amen.
The Bible said, God's not a man that he should lie, nor is he the son of man that he shall repent. For if he said it, will he not do it? How many know God is going to make it good?
Amen.
All you got to do is hold on to your faith.
That's right.
All you got to do is believe.
That's right.
The Bible said, cast not away your confidence, which have great recompense and reward.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, know that if you lose your faith, you lose your reward.
Yes.
You lose your blessing.
Yes.
So you better hold on to your faith.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hold on to your faith. Hold on to it. Don't let go. Don't let go. Don't stop believing. I don't care how hard it gets. I'm telling you, man, we were talking about Wednesday again. We were talking about Paul with the thorn in the flesh. How that Satan was sent to buffet him. The word buffet means to hit. Amen. To strike. How many know that sometimes the devil come against us to strike us so hard that he want to knock the breath out of us. He want us to quit. He want us to give up. He want us to stop. But how many know that we can't give up? Because guess what? In this season, because you did not give up, in this season, we're going to see the blessings of God. Now, let me say this. Don't sit in here and talk religious like, okay, Pastor Bond. You need to start seeking the face of God.
Amen.
You need to start fasting and praying.
Amen.
You need to get direction from God for your own personal life. Amen. You know, I can't tell you everything. Amen. You got to hear God for yourself. You got to get the anointing of God in your life. You got to seek God for yourself so he can give you direction. And that means you got to be willing to do what you need to do. That means, God, if I got to fast, that means if I got to pray, God, I'm going to do that because I need to hear your voice.
Amen. That's right.
That's how we get direction.
Yes.
And we know direction do come from the Bible, from the Logos, the written word, but leadership come from the Spirit.
Amen.
Yes, Lord.
You can use the Logos until you get a rhema, until you get the leadership of the Spirit really working on the inside of you.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that's a whole other subject there.
Okay, let's read this. Let us not be weary in well-doing.
Mm.
Did y'all hear that?
Mm-hmm.
The word weary means to faint in heart. To be spiritless. Not to have no spirit.
Mm.
Not to have no life. How many know that we're supposed to be full of spirit?
Mm-hmm.
The spirit of joy, the spirit of peace. When you look at and sometimes my eyes, God, I say, God, how am I doing this? It's not me, it's supernatural.
Amen.
How am I staying full of spirit, full of life, full of joy, full of peace? All the stuff I'm going through.
Amen.
Because of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
But when you faint, you become spiritless. You have no life. You have no joy. You have no happiness. You spend all day concerned about what's going on. And Matthew 6 tells us Man, listen, don't worry about what you're going to eat. Don't worry about what you're going to wear. Don't worry about nothing, because God's going to take care of you. He says, seek ye first what the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and everything you need will be added unto you. So let's seek the face of God. But he said, don't be weary in well doing.
Yes.
For in due season.
Yes.
Somebody said due season.
Due season.
I like this word, season. We know due means a set time, right? How many know God got a set time for you?
Amen.
I like this word season. The word season comes from the Greek word kairos. Spelled K-A-I-R-O-S. It means a set time, a sure time, a fixed time. How many know that God got a fixed or a set time for us? Amen. For each and every one of us. That he's going to move us in certain areas of our purpose and our destiny.
Yes, Lord.
That he would bless us in due season. So God has a set time. But our problem is this. We don't want to go through the chronos. We don't want to wait.
That's right.
The word chronos is another word for time, but in the Greek, it means the passing of days and of time. How many know sometimes we gotta go, sometimes God will take us through trials and tribulation for a season. We'll go through it for a season. But he said, in due season, you shall reap. You're going to gather. You're going to bring in. We shall reap if we faint not.
Yes. Hallelujah.
If we faint not.
Hallelujah.
How many know God don't want us to faint? He don't want us to give up.
Amen.
God has a due season. Somebody said due season.
Due season.
I believe that this is the due season of God. I believe that this is the kairos, the set time of God, that God is getting ready to move us into our place of blessing. And I want to encourage you today, man, don't give up. Don't quit. This is your season of blessing, your season of increase, your season of favor, that God is getting ready to do some supernatural things for us in this season.
Amen.
God has a set time. But he said, don't be weary.
Amen.
Don't give up. Because in due season, you shall reap.
That's right.
If you faint not. Amen. Amen. We thank God for tonight. We thank God for each and every one of you coming out and fellowshipping. Amen. Amen. At this time, let's go ahead. We'll take up our. I can prepare an offering. Anybody got anything to give? Let's bless the Lord with a seed.